Hello students, welcome to RAYAT online school education project conducted by RAYAT Shikshan Samstha Satara. Myself Shubhangi Jadhav from HGM College Karad. This is our fifth lecture. In the previous lecture, we studied the packing of particles in crystal lattice. We studied how the three-dimensional closest packing is done to form different kinds of crystal lattice. Okay, now in today's lecture we will study the packing efficiency of metal crystal. Now in the previous lecture we studied that though the particles in the crystal structure are closely packed, they are not occupying all the available space. Some of the space remained empty, and we named that empty space as the void. Means though in the crystal lattice there is a closest packing of the particles, but some of the part remains empty. Okay, means here that empty space, that is the void, is responsible for the packing efficiency in the crystal lattice. In the previous lecture, we have seen that how the wires are responsible for the packing efficiency in the crystal lattice. Now, let's first see the meaning of packing efficiency. See its definition. The fraction or a percentage of the total space occupied by the spheres or particles in a unit cell is called as packing efficiency. Means here, out of total volume of the unit cell, how much portion of that unit cell is occupied by the spheres is indicating the packing efficiency of that unit cell. Now, to determine this packing efficiency, we have to use this simple formula, that is volume occupied by particles in unit cell divided by total volume of unit cell and multiply it by 100. Okay, means here the volume occupied by the particles in the unit cell is expressed in terms of packing efficiency. More is the packing efficiency, larger is the closest packing. Okay, and smaller the value of packing efficiency, we can say that the closest packing is less efficient. Now in today's lecture we will calculate the packing efficiency in different kinds of unit cells. First, we will discuss the packing efficiency of metal crystal in simple cubic lattice. For that purpose, again revise the arrangement of particles in simple cubic lattice. We know that in the unit cell of simple cubic lattice, here the particles are present only at the corners. That is, 8 particles are present at 8 corners. But for our convenience, here just consider the face value, face of that unit cell. Okay, so this diagram gives us only the face portion of, that is the front portion of that unit cell. Here you will observe that there are corner particles, and these corner particles are touching with each other along the edges. So these are the edges of that cube, that is a face of that simple cubic unit cell. Now consider R as the radius of each sphere, while the edge length of that unit cell will be given in terms of A. Now, this packing efficiency of metal crystal is determined with the help of different steps. We will see that steps. The first one, that is determination of radius of sphere. Here we have to determine the radius of sphere in terms of edge length. Okay. So you can easily determine it here, since the radius of each sphere is r and they are touching with each other, we can easily say that A is equal to 2r. Okay. Therefore, we can write r is equal to A upon 2. Thus, here we have written the radius in terms of edge length. Now, see the second step. Here, you have to determine the volume of sphere. In mathematics, we know that the volume of sphere is given as 4 upon 3 pi r cube. And here, the particles are spherical in shape, and therefore, the volume of one particle will be equal to 4 upon 3 pi r cube. Now, again, we insert the value of r in terms of A with the help of first step. So, we are getting 4 upon 3 pi into A upon 2 A cube. Now, simplify this equation. You will get 4 upon 3 pi A cube into divided by 8. Again, after simplification, you will find the answer as pi into A cube upon 6. So, this value gives us the volume of one particle. Now, let's see the third step. In the third step, we have to determine the total volume occupied by the particles. And this total volume of particles can be easily calculated by knowing the number of particles present in that cubic unit cell and the volume of one particle. Here, this is a simple cubic unit cell, and we know that for this unit cell, the number of particles are only one. We have made this calculation in the previous lectures. So, the volume occupied by particle in unit cell is equal to pi into A cube upon 6. Now see the fourth step. Here in this fourth step, you have to determine the packing efficiency by using this formula. That is volume occupied by particles in unit cell divided by total volume of unit cell multiplied by 100. We know the volume occupied by particles. We have calculated or determined it in third step. While the total volume of unit cell will be given as A cube, because we know that for the simple cubic unit cell, all the edges are of same kind, and therefore the total volume becomes A cube. Now see, thus the packing efficiency is equal to pi A cube upon 6. This is a volume of the particles in that unit cell divided by A cube, that is total volume of the unit cell, into 100. After simplification, you will get pi upon 6 into 100. We know the value of pi, and therefore we can write here 3.142 upon 6 into 100. By doing this calculation, you will find that packing efficiency is equal to 52.36%. Thus, here the total space occupied by the particles in simple cubic unit cell is 52.36%, while the space which is remained unoccupied, that is the empty space or the void volume, is calculated by just subtracting the space occupied by particles from 100. Thus, the void volume will be equal to 100 minus 52.36, that is equal to 47.64%. Means here in simple cubic unit cell, the volume of the wires is comparatively more. Okay, now see the packing efficiency of metal crystal in body-centered cubic unit cell. We know how the particles are arranged in this unit cell. Here, 8 particles are present at 8 corners of the cube, while single particle is present within the body of that cube at the center. Okay, here, but for our convenience, I have shown only 2 corner particles, the centers of which are indicated by letters A and F. These are the corner particles, and the middle particle is the particle which is present at the center of the body of that cube. Now again you note down the important point that in this body-centered cubic unit cell, the particles at the center of the cube touches 2 corner particles. The particle which is present at the center of the cube touches 2 corner particles along the diagonal of the cube. So see, this is a diagonal, body diagonal of the cube. This particle A is the particle which is present at the front side, while this particle is present on the back side corner, opposite corner of the cube, and hence you can make this body diagonal as AF. Now here these corner particles are not touching with each other, or any corner particle is not touching with each other, but all the corner particles are touching to this particle which is present at the center of the body of this unit cell. So you note down this point, and we know that the number of atoms per unit cell in this is 2, and it is determined by knowing the number of particles at the corners plus the number of particles at the center of that cube. Now we will calculate the packing efficiency in a stepwise manner. In the first step, we will calculate the radius of sphere. Here, though we are expressing the radius of sphere as r, we have to express it in terms of the edge length. Now see, here for that purpose, we are considering the triangle FED. Here, I have drawn a face diagonal for our convenience by connecting the centers, that is F and D. Okay, by connecting these points, we are getting a face diagonal. Now, if you observe this triangle, you will find that the angle FED is of 90 degrees, and therefore, by Pythagoras theorem, we can write FD square is equal to FE square plus ED square. Okay. Now, again, we know that FE and ED are the edges of this cube or your cubic unit cell. And therefore, these edges are denoted by A. Thus, here we can write FD square is equal to A square plus A square, that is equal to 2A square. Now let this equation, this is first equation. Now see again the another triangle, that is triangle AFD. Now in this triangle here, angle ADF is of 90 degrees. And therefore, again, by Pythagoras theorem, we can write AF square is equal to AD square plus f d square. We know again AD is the edge length, okay, and therefore it is A, and hence AD square is equal to A square, and we determined FD, right, FD square, and in equation 1, and its value is 2A square, okay. Thus, AF square is equal to 3A square. Thus, by making the square root on both sides of this equation, we are getting AF is equal to root 3 up into A. But from figure, we can easily say that the AF is nothing but 4R, because this is a body diagonal, and along this body diagonal, all the spheres are touching to each other. So, if the radius of each sphere is R, then you can write here R plus R plus R plus R, that is equal to 4R, and this is the value of body diagonal, that is AF. Therefore, from these two equations, we can write root 3A is equal to 4R, and thus R is equal to root 3 upon 4 into A. Here we determined the radius of the sphere. Now let's see the second step. Determine the volume of sphere. Again, we know that volume of one particle is 4 upon 3 pi r cube. So, from equation 3, we can insert the value of r in this equation so that we get 4 upon 3 pi into root 3 upon 4 a cube. Okay, simplify this equation. Here you will obtain 4 upon 3 pi into root 3 cube divided by 64. The cube of 4 is 64, multiplied by a cube. Again, after simplification, you will get here 4 upon 3 pi into 3 root 3. Cube of root 3 is 3 root 3 upon 64 into a cube. And thus, here you simplify this equation, you will get the answer as volume of one particle is equal to root 3 pi a cube upon 16. So let this is equation number 4. Now determine the total volume of particles. Here for BCC unit cell, we know that the number of particles in it are 2, and therefore the total volume occupied by the particles in a unit cell will be equal to 2 into volume of one particle, that is 2 into root 3 pi into a cube divided by 16. This value is written from equation number 4. Thus, after simplification, you will get here root 3 pi a cube upon 8. In this manner, now we know the volume occupied by the particles in unit cell, and we can also determine the volume of total volume of unit cell, which is a cube. Thus, now calculate the packing efficiency by using the same formula. Therefore, packing efficiency is equal to root 3 pi a cube upon 8 a cube, okay, into 100. After solving this equation, you will get the answer as 68%. Thus, the total space occupied by the particles is 68%. Means the packing efficiency in body-centered crystal system is 68%, while the word volume or empty space is equal to 100 minus 68, that is equal to 32%. Thus, if we compare the packing efficiency in simple cubic unit cell and in body center unit cell, you can easily say that the packing efficiency in BCC unit cell is more than that of in simple or primitive unit cell. Okay, here the volume which remained empty is less. I hope you may have understood how the packing efficiency is calculated by knowing just only four steps. These derivations may be asked in exam for 3 marks, or in MCQ type of questions, the questions based on these packing efficiency or void volume are always asked. So remember well the values of packing efficiencies in these crystals and also the void volumes. Thank you.